Next, we are sowing Nicotiana lime green. Now you're probably thinking, about time. However, it's extremely light sensitive, so we needed the daylight hours to return to 14 hours of daytime for the plants to grow to their best. Now, Nicotiana are light sensitive, so if you've ever struggled with growing Nicotiana in the past, now there are different types of Nicotiana and they do have different germination instructions, so you need to check where you've got your seeds from and what varieties you've got. But if you've bought these seeds from us, they need light levels of around 14 hours and a nice warm germination period. They will bloom for us towards the end of the summer. So if you've ever struggled with growing Nicotiana, it's probably just because you've sown it at the wrong time of the year. This is Nicotiana lime green. So it's a similar color palette to what we've already got, but it's got that all important different shape. So here's our Nicotiana seed, and we've still got loads more seeds in the packet. Now, I'm going to sow them as best as I can, one or two seeds per cell. If you're going to do two seeds per cell, just put them in opposite corners so that you can separate them later when we come to potting on time. They are seriously tiny seeds. There we go. Now they need light for germination. So you can see here that I've pre-moistened my seed tray, and then that will stop me from accidentally washing the seeds into the compost. Just do the best you can. They're very easy to prick out later. Now, if all of that is a little bit too awkward for you, what you could do is get one of these quarter trays. You can get them from your local garden centre. You could use a pot. The thing with these trays is, look, they come with this little nifty lid. So all I'm going to do is scatter them over the surface of the compost. Now, the one thing you've got to be really careful of when direct sowing into a tray like this is that you space them out quite far apart. Can you see I'm sprinkling them on just as if they were salt? So each seedling, when it germinates, will have a bit of room because they're so tiny, you won't be able to prick them out for a little while. There we go, that's probably enough. Don't forget your label and then a little propagator lid over the top. These little propagator lids are really nifty because look, as those seeds start to germinate, you can open up the little vents to let them get a little bit of air while you're waiting for the rest of the seeds to come up. Don't have one of these little half trays, you don't have to go shopping. You can fashion yourself a little mini propagator by using a small pot, and then this is a pasta sauce container. And it fits the top like a propagator lid just perfectly. Look at that. It was meant to be.
Nicotiana need light for germination, so we're not going to cover the seeds. It's so tiny anyway. Clear propagator lid on top to keep the environment nice and steady and humid around the seed. They like a nice warm germination period around 20 to 22 degrees. Probably the best bet is to take them up to the house, or if you've got a heat mat. The one thing you do need to be careful this late into spring now is the temperatures in your greenhouse can vary wildly. So if you've got your hats on and you're not quick at getting down in the morning, you might find that you end up frazzling your seedlings before they've had a chance to germinate. So the safest bet would be just to take your seedlings up to the house until you see germination occur, and then just bring them down to the greenhouse, acclimatise them slowly with the lid on at night, just for a few nights until they get used to it. They're in the greenhouse, so that'd be nice and protected. They will be teeny tiny little seedlings, so you do need to be patient.
Fast forward 11 days and look, you can see germination is well underway. I've opened up the little vents. Let's take the lid off for you. And you can see how incredibly tiny they are. Much too small to attempt pricking out at this stage, so I'll leave them be. I'll leave them down in the greenhouse during the day, and at night time, because we've got seeds that are still germinating, at night time, to keep the environment nice and humid, I'll put the propagator lid on over the top. If it's nice and warm where you are, you can leave them in the greenhouse overnight. However, if we have a cold snap and frost is threatened, for example, then you'll need to take them back up to the house just for an overnight stay and bring them back down in the morning. Fast forward 6 days or 17 days since I started the seeds. They're down in the greenhouse now without a propagator lid. You can see how much the seedlings are growing with all this lovely light. And you can also see that germination is still occurring. So they're clearly happy. I'm going to leave them alone to get on with growing. We're going to have plenty of plants for our gardens, aren't we?
A day tidying up the greenhouse and feeding my plants. These are my zinnias and these are my Nicotiana, because we're cheating. We've potted these on and we've left them in the greenhouse longer than we normally would on normal years, because the field is still full up of the cool weather flowers. And they're much, much happier in here. Now, one of the best things about Nicotiana is it will grow in part shade. So you're going to be having a scout around and look out for any tricky corners that you've got in your garden. I like to plant mine by the summer house, by the steps, because that's got quite shaded for part of the day. And they grew beautifully there for me. I'll run a video for you now.
So this is the Nicotiana lime green. This is from the January seed shop and the spring grow along. Don't they look incredible? Now they will take a bit of part shade, which is ideal for this spot. It's sunny now, but from about lunchtime onwards, it starts to go into shade for the rest of the day. So they're going to be perfectly happy in this location. Thought you might like to see how I'm getting on. So I'm planting these 22 centimetres apart. Glorious, aren't they? And there we go, that looks absolutely smashing. All that's left is to give it a quick watering in. These are looking lovely, aren't they? Don't forget all the information for sowing and growing Nicotiana, including the light sensitivity, is in your spring grow along handbook.